Very interesting table, in which we have the table, and in the center we have the words Kes Lachoshech, end to darkness. Yeah, end to darkness. Like the documentary that we did with Richard Shaw, Pin Light. Then, but amazingly, I found out when really I put the words Kes Lachoshech and to darkness, and Hanukkah and Matityahu. Matityahu was the hero of Hanukkah, that's when I am, you know. And other words like menorah, candlestick. Then amazingly, I saw that all this appearance comes in a table in which every line, it means a skip, has 8,808. Amazing now. Definitely, Kabbalistically, has a very, very deep ideas, important ones. As the number 8, exactly connected with Hanukkah, 8 days, because number 8 represents supernaturally. The supernatural above the 7, 7 is natural, supernatural is 8. Also, the shape of the letter number, better to say, 8, is 2 rounds. This represents the 6, really represents the physical, the mundane, and this one, the upper one, Messiah time. By the way, the idea of a lot of secrets behind letters which and numbers, as we see in this case, has to do with Kabbalah. And it is known that Aristo, who had a lot of material on numbers, he got his wisdom, he says himself, it's a known story, from Jeremiah the prophet. So no doubt that ideas which have to do with Kabbalah and so on are involved in his explanation about numbers. 9 is right on top because it's cut off from the physical. 6 is the physical result. So number 8 represents the days of Messiah. Now Rabbi tells us something amazing. There's a the musical instrument, which now is based on 7, and we have more, but basically 7. In Messiah time, it will be 8, and in the world to come, will be 10. This also, we see it in the Psalms, which kind of instruments were played by David. One of them is Damnasech HaLashminit, on the 8th string, and then Nesen Berasor, with 10 strings now. So, David has a lot of idea, but amazingly, when I saw this 8, 8, 8, I said, exactly with the idea of Hanukkah, and also Kabbalistically, the Ramchal, Sato, and Luria says that the singles, like up till 10, that numbers are against this physical world, the tens, 10, 20, etc., up till 100, the world of formation, which is Sefer Olam HaYetzirah, then 100 represent the higher level of this, which is called the world of creation, and then above this is the world of emanation, the world of emanation is absolute, and then 10,000 is the highest world. Amazingly, so here about Hanukkah, about the end of darkness, you have exactly the right numbers. Maybe it indicates thousands, it sounds that really Hanukkah is connected very high level, you know quite well, a lot of ideas in Hanukkah, hidden light and so on is there. So this is why we see connection between the 1,000 and the 800, emanation and creation and action. But the most interesting is that the numerical value of the Ketzam Lachoshech, that he put into darkness, which is really the verse, a verse in Job, saying, Ketzam Lachoshech, God put into darkness, and it will be into darkness. So the numerical value, Ketz an 80, Psalm 340 and 358, Lachoshech, 888, represents the connection with the physical, materialistic world, to the formation of the creation. That's amazing. Then, what's more interesting is that זה איבו וורס, חג החנוכה, איתב שיניין חז, פסטיבל אוף חנוכה. This year, according to counting the years from the creation of man, which had to do the connection of Messiah, because what we have to the nine is from the time of creation of the world, which is really 1 week, and then a new year. So this is calculation, which is very suitable for Shemitah, for Jubilee, but in connection with Messiah, something future, many say that now we are in 5,778. So the numerical value of Chag HaChanukah, the festival of Chanukah, 5,778 comes to 888. Again, telling us that this Chanukah that is now coming in, very significant that all this to do with 888 cannot be coincidence, definitely not. It's all the codes of the Torah codes. There are many times we have number of letter skips, which also has a message in it. So let us see the table. So this, by the way, interesting. This is what you see on top, is a candlestick in a synagogue. And what is interesting, that the Messiah, Mashiach in Hebrew, is the abbreviation of Madlikin Shmonat Yemei Chanukah. We are kindling 8 days in Chanukah. First letter, Mashiach. Again, connection to Chanukah and Messiah. Now let us see the very interesting table and what is it, and why it is so interesting. Now the first thing, when I put the words which are connected with Kes, Lachosher, and to darkness, Matityahu, the Azmaniah, not me, the Matityahu, the Azmaniah, this is in fact the second minimal in the Torah of Matityahu, and coming together with the end of darkness cannot be coincidence, because this is what Dr. Rothenberg, whose program we are using, yeah, became himself Orthodox Jews keeping Sabbath and everything, because he saw in it the clear proof from Torah from heaven. So this is the program that we are using, and he said, but meeting are the most important. So we have the best meeting of Matityahu and end of darkness and the Maccabite, by the Maccabee, yeah, Maccabee, Matityahu, but the Maccabite, you have Maccabite here. And then you have Messiah. But what is interesting, look here what is written. This is what shows you always the number of the letters in the skip. 8,808. Amazing, I did not decide for this number. It came out by itself. So, what you have more here, which is interesting, you have Messiah. Because Messiah said Chanukah is a time which is very much connected with Messiah, because lots of ideas of Chanukah has to do. In fact, the Hebrew word Chanukah is chinuch, education for the future redemption. A lot of things of Chanukah, we are learning how to prepare ourselves for the future redemption. In Chanukah, we had a war with the Greeks, you know, physically and spiritually. With the Greeks themselves, who want to wipe out Judaism, which is the base of Judaism, to defile, contaminated all this oil, and Jews who unfortunately joined the philosophy also, mitzvahim. So it was physical and spiritual war, like today we have in Israel, the same thing. In Israel, we have the physical, we want to wipe us out, Iran, Hezbollah, Jihad. Then, from the other side, we have Jews, unfortunately, who support them. Also, they say we should give back to the Arabs, and we. And not Torah against Sabbath, if it's on the Sabbath. And many things are against Judaism, against the Torah. So exactly the same kind of problems that we have today in Israel, we had in the time of Chanukah. And like in Chanukah, small group, and we managed to wipe out all these, you know, Greeks, all this empire, with the help of God, and Matityahu, he was in the head of this. So this is what you have here. Right. So Maccabite, you have Maccabi, you have and to darkness, you have Matityahu. And then you have interesting, which is so important in codes, the location where it appears. So here is Zichri Yakib, comes out in the story. The Torah tells about the tent of testimony in tabernacle. And there was a menorah candlestick, which this candlestick of Chanukah reminds us, this is exactly the same thing. Yaleh Nerot, then they brought up candles, amazing, comes here. Then what you have also to understand, that is a memorah, but you have here Chanukah, you can see Chanukah come here, and here also you have, this is what is very interesting, the son of Jesse, Ben Ishai, because it is connected with the Messiah, Messiah also, Mashiach also. And then you have the word Hageulah. Hageulah means a real redemption, the spiritual, not physical one. Because the idea of Geulah in Kabbalah is Geulah is like Gal revealing the godliness, which is really the letters of God, Aleph Vav A, yeah, which is the letters which Amalek had covered. But Geulah represents spiritual, this is what we hope we will have. By the way, you have also the word code, soften, because part of the end of darkness is the codes, the Torah codes, the Bible codes, as we prove in many things, like we can see in many appearances in Richard Shaw, in the internet, you know, if you present to darkness, you find the many places, it really shows clearly that by the codes, we find out a lot of ideas that before were covered from us. Now we understand them, many things. Another connection of the location is unbelievable. It's written here about the beginning of the creation. V'choshech al pnei teom was darkness on top of the depths. V'ruach Elokim, and the Spirit of God, merachepet apnai, was hovering over the water. V'yomer Elokim, God said, Ye'ior, let it be light, and light came out. Our rabbis tell us, in fact, there are four expressions, you have Choshech, and you have Teom, and then you have also other expressions, but the Choshech, our rabbis tell us, represent the kingdom of the Greeks, because the Greeks were the first ones who want to brought darkness to the world by covering the light of the Torah, covering God, so it is darkness, Choshech. By the way, now is written also interesting idea, the letter Choshech, represent Chamor, the donkey, the shore, the ox, and the Kelev, the dog. All of them represent nations. Chamor is the Arabs, you know, unfortunately those who want to wipe out Islam. Shin is shore, the ox represent Edom, yeah, Europe. And Kelev, dog, represent Amalekite, the terrorists. And those who are really combined the evil of the right and the left. I mean, so this is Choshech. But what is the idea that the Midrash says that in the end, darkness will finish, will be light. Yeah. Then, Ruach Elokim al pnei ha'mayim. Now, says the Midrash, Ruach Elokim, the Spirit of God, is hovering over the water. Says the Midrash, unbelievable, that it refers to the spirit of Messiah which should come, hovering on the water, water, water. Water represents prayers, represents the heart, and so on. And this is what is written, that it will be a situation where really the Spirit of God will come, and people really will start realizing emotionally that there is a God, the spiritual values, and so on. In fact, one of the rabbis who lived a while ago, the Chida says that the numerical value of Merachefet, hovering, is a year 5, 7, 3, 2, 8, which is exactly after the sixth Devor. And after the sixth Devor, really the yeshivot, the institution of repentance, of people who repented, started, or Sameach, Esha Torah. And then light came, the light of the Torah. So it said, unbelievable table, in fact you have the word Shuvah also, repentance, yeah, coming from the top. But altogether, such a table with so many words into darkness, Matithyahu, the Maccabites, the code, the Messiah, the son of Jesse, redemption, real redemption, full of God, repentance, and the menorah, ha-menorah, the candlestick, the light, all of this coming in a skip of 8808. Kind of a coincidence, and definitely all the Torah is not a coincidence. If you really follow properly the YouTube, you see what's but many people I see, unfortunately, are looking at it very superficially. And from their comments, I see that unfortunately, miss the most important thing. Like many people said, what it is now, it is 779, what is 70? But I say clearly, that's our opinion of, like, say, the Olam and some other we are now in this because this is the time to do with the Messiah, should start from the creation of man. So make make an effort to follow properly my YouTubes. It's a little bit difficult in English, but try to. And then you will see as the truth come out and realize, let's assume that people realize only the blueprint of creation was the Torah. Only in 5 books we have this. We don't even say Bible, definitely in other books. You will never find such a table in the Bible. Not only this, but exactly even the code, it means the skip of the point. What you find in the Bible, you know, you find Messiah and you put the name that you like to, and your Messiah is this person, this person. But to have such a full description of a situation which fits with the Torah, which fits with exactly what the Medrash said about the darkness, fits with the word Menorah in the temple, which is exactly all connected, you will never find a thing. So let us hope that people will really follow my YouTube properly and will understand much more. And this program, you know, Dr. Rothenberg, he became a religious Jew, Orthodox Jew, keeping the Torah and everything. But it's so clearly, it's such a phenomenon. Definitely it cannot be. And there are scientists who say the same, you know, but it's difficult to become religious Orthodox. You have to keep the Sabbath, you can go to the sea, and so on. You have Jews, yeah. So, they don't say, no, it is a nice game, but it's far away. Scientists say it is very, very serious. And great rabbis say that one should spread it and show it, because this is a clear proof that Torah is from heaven. We see professors like Michelson, yeah, from Harvard, became religious, Dr. Rosenberg, others, when they saw that this is the truth, they kept the Torah. And in this merit of keeping the Torah, doing tshuva, we will have Messiah coming soon. We're hoping in this Hanukkah already.